Another cool thing, if you do have a camcorder attached to it, you can actually do a live crossover to the camcorder as well. So you could activate that. I don't have one attached, but you'll just feed in whatever's coming in on the video camera. We've got Clipbank here. Now Clipbank is a feature here that where it lets you select a few short video clips. So for example, if you had a very short video or advertising, if you're a mobile DJ or anything like that, then you can just run your ad while the music's playing and just let that play. So this is just a video of some guy scratching. And you can have up to 12 of them, so you can quickly cross to that. I won't get onto karaoke, as you can see there, because I don't have a karaoke plugin, but it can play karaoke video files as well. Negative audio, video effects, pretty self-explanatory. You have a slideshow as well. Now the slideshow is a pretty cool one. It just lets you just basically do a slideshow of images, JPEGs and things like that. Again, if you're a mobile DJ, a working DJ or anything like that, you can just have, you know, your ads or things like that. Another video effect is it has here is Sonique. Now Sonique are third-party plugins. So if you're using some audio and you don't have a video clip for it, you can actually use these plugins, and what they do is provide some kind of animation for it. So I'll activate that. And you've just got something happening there, which makes it a lot interesting. So then you can go from video clip to you know, to video or to the animation, and you've got a transparency as well. Now there's a few choices of them. I could do a slideshow, and that'll just go through a whole range of different animation. Then you've got a strobe as well, which, as you can kind of see, just starts as the video. And towards the end, we've got text. Text, again, is another handy one, you know. Just allows us to send messages out to audience. So if you're working in a club and the manager says, hey look, we got free drinks, or not free drinks, but cheap drinks, you know, from 10 p.m. or 8 p.m. onwards, cool, just send a message to everyone, you know, everyone in the club. And this is a pretty good way to get it. And obviously you can adjust the size and all that, and the colour palette here. You know, it's not a full word process
to get you a drink.
Yeah, something like that. So you can use that. And then you also have a little title option here, which, to be honest, I wouldn't use that much, but basically just scrolls the name of the file. So it gives it that kind of video clip kind of look as well. So there are the video effects. Then you have different kinds of video transitions, and what they are basically similar to, like, for those of you familiar with DJ, you know, you've got audio curves and things like that. Video transitions are just the ways you go from one video to another. So, try that again. So there's two ways I can access that, either through this effects section here or through this drop down menu here. So you can see I've got quite a few. So that was a straight one, this cube, which is pretty cool. So there's a whole list here of different transitions you can have. Fade's another good one. The 3D is a pretty cool one. This one's a favourite, Say Like Boom, because basically the transitions are synchronised to tempo. And you've got a few other choices here as well. You know, window, and white is pretty cool as well. So you've got a few different ways of going from video to video, so to suit whatever music you're playing. So if you're going into a ballad or whatever, you know, you can choose the transition you want. So that's pretty much all the main kind of effects and transitions you have on Digi DJ. Now the application itself is pretty robust. You can probably see a bit of my CPU is kind of maxing out here, and this is only a Centrino, so it's, unfortunately I should complain at work because it's a 4-year laptop. But the files it's playing, they're about 120 meg video files, so they're pretty decent resolution. So if I was to put this up on a panel, it would look quite good. And the program's still doing quite a good job. Now most people these days would have like a Duo or something like that, even the processing, so it would handle it extremely easy. Another good thing about PC DJ, VJ, is that you don't have to use it with this controller. You can use it with other MIDI controllers. So, for example, I could have this controller acting as my main kind of playback type deck. You know, using this for the platter and you know, traditional functions I'd use as a DJ. Then I can go into setup and add. I'll just wait for that to appear. Add a few other options. Now, as you can see, there's a few other templates for other third-party controllers. I could also add a MIDI control here, so I could add another controller, so keep this for my main functions, again, as I mentioned, as a traditional DJ-type product, and then go into here and set up another MIDI controller, just a third-party one with knobs, or I mean, even something like the Motion Dive with Crossfader. I could add that in, and then use the MIDI Learn facilities and assign some of the functions that aren't assigned to this to another MIDI controller. So that way I could add, you know, whatever settings I prefer or use on a regular basis. So it kind of gives you that flexibility as well. You can also, you have a few other options as well. As I mentioned before, you will bring in the bring in the next track at the same tempo. You can disable that feature. It's kind of like a bit of cheating in terms of DJing, but yeah, sometimes it makes the job easier. And as I mentioned, obviously you can use ASIO interface as well. Now you can use a lot of different files, so you can use MPEGs, AVIs, even karaoke files. Obviously you can use WAV and MP3 as well for audio files, and you can import JPEGs into the slideshow effect as well. So you can kind of have a lot of things going. There is some more advanced usage here as well. You've got little loop markers that you can adjust here for even better synchronized mixing, and you've got more cue points, you've got up to 8, so you can kind of really get involved with this program, and you've got different zoom levels as well, so if you want to kind of see what's happening with the track. So that's pretty much VJ, and obviously, as I mentioned, it makes great combination with the HC4500 controller, because you do have that native support, feeds the information back. Having said that, they will have native support for future Denon controllers, like the HS5500 and other ones as well, and or else you can actually use it with the mouse. Not as fun, but yeah, you can still get away with it. But yeah, that's pretty much VJ and the Denon controller.
Cool.
So any questions?
When you take it out, so if you took it out to do this, you'd have to take what you've got in front of you, but
It depends, because
you didn't want to take like that around. You don't want to take that around as well, and you get there and you've got a mixer and like say two CDJs. Would you be able to hook that up to the program?
Yeah, you would. I mean, it depends how you set it up. It's got this interface has two audio outputs, so you can assign it to right now. Set it to left and right. So basically. So that's on one channel, and that's on the other channel. Now I could assign them to the same output as well, but I suppose the problem you're going to run into there is headphone queuing. You know, you're still going to need some way of headphone queuing, so a traditional mixer would help. Otherwise, you would need some kind of way of connecting the headphone to the second output as well, which you can do internally, but it depends on the options, you know. I mean, how you're comfortable with it. I mean, I personally would use a, you know, like a mixer for the audio. So that way you can, you know, do EQs. You've got that kind of quick access. Even though you can do it here, you know, more hands-on control, the better, I suppose. And then, and you can just have a video coming out of the second VJ port on your computer. Yeah, so I suppose in summary, yeah, you can kind of get away with it, but it would be a lot more handy to have a mixer. And you wouldn't have to bring your own mixer. You'd just plug it into whatever, as long as it's like a decent mixer that has four channels or two spare channels, you can plug it in and go. Yeah. Any other questions?
In terms of the video clips, mm-hmm. can you edit multiple video clips and extract them into a separate file and then display those favorite parts of the video clips?
You can actually record. So you would still have to perform it like a DJ mix. It's, you know, obviously it's not like a video type editing program, but you could still record that. I probably wouldn't be able to do it with this computer because it's too slow. So you could capture your kind of whole mix, really. You know, you could do a whole video type mix and capture that. I'm not 100% sure on what format it records it in, but yeah, you can do that.